Don't forget to hit subscribe and click the bell for notifications. Today, once again, I'm coming to you from Gateway Classic Cars over here outside of St. Louis, Missouri. And today I thought you might like a look at this 1979 Jeep CJ-7. And this one's been modified, I think, in all the right ways. So I thought you might like taking a look at it here. I just first off like the stance of this thing. Somebody's put some 35s on there. Those are 35-inch tires by 12.5 wide on some 15-inch rims. And I think it's got just the right amount of lift, so it's not that bad to climb up into, but it'd still be very capable off-road, and I think it just has a tough look to it. Nice chrome bumper up front here. Then you got the Rough Country 9500 pound winch, so that's pretty stout and definitely grabs your attention in that yellow, no doubt about it. And you can see it's got all the nice little chrome accessories. I mean, it's like a show Jeep. Very nice. Nice aluminum wheels. I believe those might be Eagle alloy wheels, but I'm not sure. Got the manual locking hubs. And it's got headers going into side exit exhaust. Nice little rocker plates there. Like I said, nice bits of chrome everywhere. I mean, it's in beautiful condition. Take a peek inside here. Of course, these are pretty simple vehicles, very utilitarian. Just manual roll-up windows. And basically just have what you need and not too much extra. Nice three-spoke wheel. I like these tall back bucket seats. And of course you got your roll bar. This one does have a flip-up sunroof as well. And you got your original speedometer. And all your auxiliary gauges. Someone has put a later model stereo in here at some point. You got a console with cup holders and an armrest. Yeah, very cool. Probably one of the biggest changes is under the hood here. Let me get this open, we'll take a look. Alright, now that I have the hood tipped up here, you can see they've actually swapped in a 5.7 liter Chevrolet LT1 V8. So a 350 cubic inch V8 with fuel injection. Put some nice headers on there as well. So that's a pretty significant bump in horsepower over what they came with. And the fuel injection is really nice off-road because you don't have to worry about any issues with being on inclines, that sort of thing. Nice Optima battery in here as well. And you can see it's all painted up nicely under here. But they did a great job on the swap. It's really well done. Definitely plenty of power for this thing. But yeah, that LT1 will definitely wake that thing up quite a bit. You know, this size vehicle, I'm sure it moves down the road pretty well. Now, I did notice out back here, you got some little bubbling issues on the corner, so you might want to address that, because the rest of the Jeep's in really nice condition. So this is really the only thing I've seen that you might want to deal with. Got the fold down tailgate there. Of course, that's hinged to open up back here. Rear bumper to match the front. Of course, you got a hitch back here. same issues on this corner. But like I said, once you address that issue, the rest of it's in beautiful condition. Very nice. Here, we'll go ahead and check out the specs here. Once again, it's a 1979 Jeep CJ-7. And 84,000 miles on the odometer, but of course that's kind of a moot point at this point because it's all been swapped over. But you guys can read all the details there. And if you need additional info, you can always go to the website at gatewayclassiccars.com. They have tons of additional photos, video clips, and all the information you could possibly need. But anyway, guys, I just thought you'd like a quick look at that one. Like I said, it caught my attention just because it's got the right stance to it. I like that it's got plenty of tire on it, but it doesn't sit up too high. So it's just a very usable Jeep. And just has that tough look. But hopefully you guys found it interesting as well. And as always, we do appreciate you watching and commenting. And if you haven't already, click subscribe, and we'll have many more videos on the way. Thanks again. Bye.